name's Shani. And what's your name? Love the name. It's so great to meet you. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm kind of glad to finally have some company on board. Yeah, I've been a little bored. I saw you just got on. Isn't it exciting? It's like magic. Okay, well, I did see you were a little hesitant. Can't say I blame you, though. It's pretty weird that a train just pulled up in our front lawns in the middle of the night. Actually, do you mind telling me, what state or country are we in right now? Oh, okay. That makes sense. Well, believe it or not, I was one of the very first stops on this train. And it's going so fast. We've traveled quite a distance. Yeah. Crazy how fast this is going. I guess it makes sense. I mean, it has to get us to our destination and back quickly. At least before our parents wake up, right? Where's it going? Well, to the North Pole and back, of course. Yeah, to the North Pole. You didn't know where it was going. So you just hopped on a random train, you had no idea where it was going? Didn't your parents ever teach you not to talk to strangers? Or to get in random vehicles? Well, you do have your ticket, right? Your ticket. You have to have your ticket. The conductor's gonna punch it. So we can go there and back. You can't lose your ticket. Check your pocket. Yeah, it looks like this. Isn't it pretty? I just love the color. The Polar Express. Round trip. And then the cool train picture on the back. What number are you? I'm number 0001225. We're only a couple numbers away from each other. Believe it or not, I've always wanted one of these tickets. I can't believe I'm finally holding one. Yeah, my father rode this train when he was younger, and he told me all about it. I can't believe I'm actually finally on the train. I hope they let me keep the ticket. Rode this train way back when. He tells me the story every Christmas. So every year I've been looking out my window hoping that the train would come by. I can't believe it finally came by this year. Yeah. Well, why do you think we'd be going to the North Pole? To meet Santa, of course. Santa Claus. You don't believe in Santa? Well, who do you think brings you all those presents every year? Ugh, please don't say your parents. You realize there's no way your parents are going to be able to get that many presents into your house, right? Just because you can't see Santa doesn't mean that Santa's not real. I mean, you can't see air, and air is real. You can't see the wind, and wind is real. Just because your friend told you and your uncle told you doesn't mean that that's true. Well, don't worry. When we get to the North Pole, you'll see Santa and you'll definitely believe. You know, you kind of remind me of my father. Yeah, he said that when he rode the train, he was starting to question if whether or not he believed in Santa too. And then one night, the train pulled up into his driveway, and then he hopped on, and he got to meet some homeless ghost, and he made a couple friends. He was telling me about the great hot chocolate they have on the train, so I've been waiting patiently for that. And then he said that he got to see Santa's workshop in the North Pole. Yeah, and he said that every year, and this is my favorite part, Santa picks one of the kids on the train to receive the first Christmas gift. Can you believe it? And even more, my father was the one who got picked to receive the first gift. Isn't that crazy? And you want to know even more of a secret? Gave it to me. Do you want to see it? Okay, I'll show you. Isn't it pretty? What is it? Well, it's a bell, of course. What's so special about a bell? Well, it's not just any bell, silly. It was from Santa. And it's the most beautiful sounding bell I've ever heard. It's not broken. Do you not hear that? I swear, I'm not joking. No, this isn't a prank. You really don't believe in Santa, do you? My father told me the only people who can't hear the bell are people who don't believe. How sad that must be. I swear it's not a prank. But don't you worry. When we get to the North Pole and you see Santa, next time I ring that bell, you're gonna hear it. Just you wait, I promise. We can't be far. We've made a couple stops since then. And the snow is getting heavier, so we've got to be close. Isn't snow beautiful? I just wish it wasn't so cold. My father said you'll know when we're getting close. I don't see anything yet. Thank you. Look, we got hot chocolate. I just love hot chocolate. And it's in a cute little snowman mug. And it's got the little marshmallows and everything. It's so good. Nothing better than hot cocoa on a cold day like today. The only thing is that cocoa makes me sleepy. And I'll be darned if I'm falling asleep before I meet Santa Claus. What did you ask Santa for Christmas this year? Yeah? That's a good idea. I know you don't believe in Santa, but you had to ask someone for something, right? I asked for a puppy. I hope I get it. I wonder if you'll know who we are. I hope you're not on the naughty list for not believing. I'm just joking. Do you have any siblings? Well, tell me a little bit about your family. They sound great. I'm one of six siblings myself, and I'm a twin. Yeah. They didn't wake up to get on the train, though. Yeah, maybe next year. I hope I'll get to ride the train with them. I think we're getting close. Excited. Me too. I'm gonna be so tired tomorrow.